late at night, hit a pinnacle. Shining on them, I'd rather drip alone. Put those on game who didn't know the true form of pure evil's invisible, so I keep a lot of vision.
Every night I try to reason, when it's you, see your eyes. Don't let me catch up, I won't waste your time, cause I'll never know it's.
Maybe, yeah, we can go up. Feeling just don't stop in that. Try to hate on us. Ain't worried about a thing, since I'm strong enough. The feeling just don't stop in that. Maybe, yeah, we can go up. Maybe, yeah, we can go up.
Welcome to, to another episode of Smackdown. We're kicking off with Adam Cole, who has come to call out Buddy Murphy for his attack on his Undisputed Era brother, Roderick Strong. I don't believe in anything handed to me. When I want something, I take it. And I'm out here tonight to grab another shot of glory. That's what I do. I don't want to be spoon-fed opportunities. A real man goes out and makes his own luck. Change his promo attitude. One superstar really pisses me off. I can't stand his voice, I can't stand his face, I can't stand the way he looks. I just want to punch him in his dumb big dumb face and just smash him until you can't recognize him. I want to destroy him. He's looking out for his brother. You know what I like? I like watching those career respective videos they do when a guy retires. I like him so much, I want to get another one made. So Buddy Murphy, come out here so I can end your career.
Oh, I'm calling out Buddy Murphy. Threatening his career as well.
He's called out Buddy Murphy, but here comes not Daniel Bryan, it's Seth Rollins. I don't know why it's Daniel Bryan's thing on this, in this only. It's only on this bit. It's like Rowan on Javis. Here comes Seth Rollins, who took out Ricochet last week on SmackDown. Comes the Messiah.
Seth Rollins entering the ring. Well, look what we've got here. Man who fancies himself a real WWE superstar. That's good, because here in the WWE, superstars have to earn their place. That's exactly why I'm out here. The microphone keeps changing.
What?
Look at it.
It does do that, doesn't it? When you step into my ring, you better be prepared for what's going to happen next. Do you know what's going to happen next? Clearly you don't, since you're already stupid enough to enter. Why is he doing that?
All you people need to sit down and shut your mouths, because I have something to say. There's nothing I hate more than a liar. And for the past few minutes, you've been listening to someone and hanging on every single word he said. Now that I'm out here, all these foolish lies can stop.
I can't listen to another word of this. I'm in serious danger of vomiting right here and right now. I think you should get out of here before I either puke or knock you out.
I think you've been hit in the head one too many times. Because it sounds to me like you want a match. You're going to find out the hard way why I'm the best pure athlete in the WWE.
I'd be happy to fight you, after you've proven yourself worthy of a fight, because frankly, I haven't seen it yet. You're still amateurish to me. Go out, fight some other superstars and really show me what you've got. Maybe then I'll consider a match with you. I really hate his, but fuck, what's his attitude?
It's like,
jovial?
Yeah, crazy or something.
Oh!
They're from Rollins. What the hell, just kicking Adam Cole right in the groin.
Oh. Cole breaks out of it.
Fighting back now.
Super kick there. Oh. Blindside attack from Seth Rollins onto Adam Cole. Oh, Adam Cole now takes down Seth Rollins. Adam Cole fighting back.
He's begging to stop with super kicks.
Another one as well. It's a super kick party. And Cole takes down Seth Rollins. Embarrasses Seth Rollins after the groin kick. What the hell about his friend?
We'll cut to backstage and these two still going war of words with each other. Adam Cole and Seth Rollins are still going at it backstage. After the embarrassment that Adam Cole gave Seth Rollins. Rollins isn't happy. Oh. Sling blade. Rollins got a chair. Yeah, Cole. Oh. Brutal attack. Adam Cole started it. He came back looking for Seth Rollins. That is true. Oh god, Seth Rollins got planned here. An exploder. Oh my god. He's inside the table. Beating down Adam Cole. I think Cole's moved. He's on concrete. Rollins. Oh my god. He's still not done with him. It's enough, Rollins. Oh. Using that trash can as a weapon. Oh no. I think Adam Cole has moved. This is the lifeless body of Adam Cole and Seth Rollins. I mean, he did start at Cole, but Seth Rollins just now just taking it all, doing to the TV screen. Once again. Oh, oh my god, one final crushing blow from
Seth. Oh, we now cut back to the ring with Randy Orton, WWE Champion. He wants to call out the new number one contender, Big E. A lot of you have made jokes about me, posted funny pictures of me, you'll laugh when I come out here. You all think you're so clever. Well, no one is laughing anymore. When I'm done, no one is ever going to be laughing ever again. We're kind of reaching a point here. I'm starting to wonder if this is all an elaborate joke. Like, manager just wants to see how far they can push me before I throw up my hands and said, okay, you've got me. The level of talent I've had to deal with, that's what it seems like. But whatever, here we are. I know all you think I'm cold-hearted and brutal, a man who thinks only of himself, and yes, I am those things, but I'm also a generous man, a man who believes in giving when the occasion calls for it. And tonight, I'm going to give Big E the chance of a lifetime, the chance to prove himself by taking down the best of the best. What do you say? Here comes the number one contender. We won a battle royal last episode of SmackDown. Here comes Big E. Oh, Jesus. God.
What's wrong with SmackDown?
You're fucking weird. Big E's got a lot of energy tonight. We'll give him that.
I'm going to come out here and do you a favor. I'm going to give you a chance to turn around, march back up that ramp, and forget that you even considered messing with me. Unless, of course, you want to embarrass yourself more than you already have, in which case, throw it down.
You've got a lot of guts coming out here and facing me in the ring. Although maybe it's not guts. Maybe you're just too stupid to realize you're in over your shoulders. Yeah, let's go with that one for now.
Everyone here has had enough of you. You had your moment. Now get out of the way. Go on, seriously, get out of this ring. I mean it. Don't make me do something you're going to regret. I'm warning you.
That's a lot of big talk for someone who constantly comes up short. You need to actually be good in the ring in order to talk like that. Oh well, to have anybody take what you say seriously.
We keep going back and forth like this all night, or we can settle this like superstars. Time to talk is over. Let's see what you can do in this ring. I want to see if you're as good as a wrestler as you are a talker. If you catch my drift.
Believe me. You don't really want to walk down this road. I can already see this end of this journey and it's me standing tall. You really want to waste your time embarrassing yourself like that? Be kind to yourself and just stop now. Oh, those words must have really got to Big E. Another brawl's on. Here we go, Randy Orton and Big E now going at it. Randy Orton's one-sided assault right now.
And Big E counters that offense there from Orton.
Oh, God.
Brawl now, coming on the top rope.
Oh, Randy Orton is flying. Oh! I think he gets back up and takes down the WWE champion.
Oh, the refs get involved now, holding back Big E.
Here comes the Celtic Warrior Sheamus, who should have been in a good mood after losing 2 weeks ago at Unforgiven. He went wrong. Celtic Warrior has to say here tonight. Microphone. What's up, Dodo Universe? I hope you're ready for a great show tonight, because I know I am. I'm sure you're wondering why I'm so unbeat after losing my match. Well, let me tell you. What's he got to say? You beat me. Congratulations. Now that's out of the way, a warning. That will never happen again. You know why? Because now you are marked. And when you are marked, bad things will happen. Quickly, Sheamus has turned. I'm out here, not out here to make excuses. I'm here because I'm a glutton for punishment. I want to get inside the ring with you again, and I will tear the whole damn building down if that's what it takes to defeat you. Let's go to war one more time. All you have to do is come out here and accept my challenge.
Sheamus throwing down the challenge.
Here comes the United States Champion.
Hold on a minute. This doesn't make any sense. How can you stand in that ring and say these things instead of they used to believe you? I'm out here right now to do something you don't seem capable of. Telling the truth.
Not exactly endearing yourself to me or the WWE Universe by coming out here right now. I get it, nobody likes to lose, especially after we tore the house down. Shouldn't be sore about it, you should be proud. I'm with Sheamus.
He's talking about losing. That Samoa Joe lost the match. Samoa Joe knows he won. He's the one with the gold.
My game, this was good.
He's the one with the gold.
I had that match in the bag. There's no doubt about that. The fact that you beat me makes no sense. I can't sleep, I can't eat. All you're thinking about is how the hell you managed to beat someone so out of your league. You couldn't have won fairly, no way. Yeah, you didn't win fairly because you didn't win.
We just talked about how you lost.
Yeah.
Look at me when I'm talking to you. Because I'm going to say this once, I beat you in the ring, 1, 2, 3, I'm the champion, you are not, so if you don't get out of my ring, I'm going to take this title and shove it down your throat.
Nobody in the universe thinks she deserves to be champion, especially me. I don't care if you beat me, it doesn't matter. I'm still better than your uncoordinated, untalented ass any day of the week. You owe me a rematch. If you give it to me, I'm sure management will.
They're like talking like the other people.
Do you think that I won't be your fighting champion because, brother, you're messing with the wrong guy? I have no problem getting this ring with you again and lining up for the WWE Universe. Hell, I'm ready to go right now.
It was good to start.
That was just not no.
I don't know what's happening. You're going to give me my rematch. I don't care if I have to hijack this entire show until you give in. But I'm getting my rematch. Do you hear me? Everything in this ridiculous town will be at a standstill until I get what I want. Punks like you don't deserve to be champion. Give me my shot, now. He said now.
Very confusing exchange, but Sheamus lays down a headbutt on Samoa Joe.
A headbutt?
Headbutt City here on SmackDown. Oh no!
The high knee from the Celtic Warrior.
Oh, we're on the hands. Oh, again. I don't know what Sheamus was talking about during that confrontation just there. Samoa Joe gets taken outside the ring by Sheamus. These two are brawling outside the ring. Samoa Joe. Oh. And the barricade. Main event time. We have a match announcement for Bad Blood.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall. Making his way to the ring from Aberdeen, Washington. Weighing in at 210 pounds, Daniel Bryan.
We have two new matches to announce. So the first match is going to be a 2 out of 3 falls match for the United States Champion between Sheamus and Samoa Joe. And this match has implications to a Bad Blood match, because at Bad Blood there will be a Fatal 4-Way match. where the winner of that match will face the WWE Champion, who that be Big E or Randy Orton, at SummerSlam. So there'll be four matches, and the winner of those four matches will go on to Bad Blood. So tonight we have Daniel Bryan taking on Pete Dunne.
Bad match, he goes with it. And SmackDown.
Dunne probably very angry getting eliminated near the end of the over-the-top rope battle royal, and as sees Big E having a big opportunity at Bad Blood. Well, Pete Dunne can get a victory here tonight, we'll get an opportunity, another opportunity for the WWE Championship. This goes through former WWE, former Intercontinental Champion Daniel Bryan. Start the match. Single leg takedown, down goes Pete Dunne.
Oh, nice counter there. Bryan's a bit stunned there.
Nice kick there from Pete Dunne, takes down Daniel Bryan. Oh, another one. Down goes Daniel Bryan. Dunne got planned here. Pole driver. Oh! That's illegal! Pete Dunne can jog on the top rope. Oh, look at that. Right in the midsection of Daniel Bryan. Oh! Another drop kick down goes Pete Dunne. Once again, if that ain't broke, don't fix it. German suplex there from the Bruiserweight. Bruiserweight in control of this match. I don't know, bro, hasn't really gotten going just yet. Yeah, hungry Pete Dunne is. But oh! One count there.
What a move, Bryan's retaking. They're already putting it back to his neck, man. He's back on his side.
What did you do over there? Oh, nice. Step up in Zagiri there from the Bruiserweight, Pete Dunne. On again to the top rope. He's in the top rope very well in this matchup. To his advantage here. We saw Daniel Bryan try to use it at the start. Didn't go as well as intended. Pete Dunne. Oh god. Daniel Bryan catches. Oh,
nobody hurt him there.
Competitors missing each other. Pete Dunne with a German suplex out of nowhere.
Nice German there.
No. Oh.
just must all do this.
Vintage Daniel Bryan.
Oh, winding up there. Bryan feeling it here.
Dunne! Oh!
Dunne Bryan inside out.
He sends the bitter end here for Daniel Bryan. Oh, right at the counter. Oh the yes kicks. Yes kicks, down goes Pete Dunne. And the yes, running knee, sorry.
Yes kick, running knee there.
Oh! Daniel Bryan thought he had it.
Dunne, the strength kicks out. Bryan then going to the top.
Oh! I think it was a lifeless move from Pete Dunne. I don't think he really knew what he did. He hasn't moved since.
Back again. Diving headbutt. Oh, oh, nobody hurt him this time. He's got baseball of canvas there.
Oh, nice there from Bryan. Takes down Pete Dunne.
Dunne in a lot of trouble here. Bryan's momentum. He's meant to swing in Bryan's favor here, but.
Oh, back body drop there. Oh!
Bryan, just from this burst of energy, hasn't been taken down. This move is tugging with the neck and head area of Bryan. Bryan pushes up this time.
Oh, a kick to the back. Got a yes lock locked in.
Yes lock locked in now on Pete Dunne. Is Pete Dunne going to tap here?
He's prawned the ropes. And
Pete Dunne does
not make it.
Daniel, he tried with all his might, but Daniel Bryan's made him tap out.
And he would advance to Bad Blood and be the first competitor in the Fatal 4-Way. Well done to Daniel Bryan. Pete Dunne, unfortunately, very upset he couldn't get the win here. But thank you for watching this episode of SmackDown. I hope you enjoyed it. Please like and subscribe if you did. Tune in for Raw, SmackDown, Bad Blood, anything else we got going on the channel. Thank you and goodbye.